How to start a blog on Siteground, Siteground WordPress tutorial. Hey guys, Brian with WP Cupid Blog, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to start and create a blog on Siteground. Starting a blog on Siteground is now easier than ever. By the end of this video, you will know how to start a blog on Siteground. This is an easy to follow Siteground WordPress tutorial. I'll be providing you with a Siteground hosting discount of up to 60% off shortly. Make sure you subscribe to our channel as we are always posting new WordPress tutorial videos. Let's get started with the steps on how to start a blog with Siteground. I'll be going over four different steps. Step one is how to sign up for an account with Siteground. Step two is choosing a hosting plan where you can get up to 60% off Siteground hosting. Step three is registering a domain name. Step four is installing and setting up WordPress on Siteground. And then I'll be going over WordPress so you can get familiar with the basics. To get your Siteground discount consisting of up to 60% off Siteground hosting, just click the link below in the description and the discount is automatically applied. A little disclosure, the link is an affiliate link. I will receive a commission which helps support this channel and helps us put out WordPress tutorial videos on a regular basis. A little about Siteground. Siteground currently powers over 1 million domains worldwide. They provide 24/7 technical support. They provide a 30-day money-back guarantee, 99.9% uptime guarantee, free daily backups of your site, and they provide free SSL certificates with all their hosting plans. Setting up WordPress on Siteground only takes a few clicks of a button. If you haven't already, feel free to click the Siteground link in the description to walk through the steps with me to start and create a blog on Siteground. Let's get started. After you click the link, you'll be at the Siteground web hosting page. This is where you can select your hosting plan. You will see three different plans: a startup plan, grow big plan, and a go geek plan. The most popular plan is the Grow Big plan. This plan is good if you plan on having more than one website. This plan also comes with premium features which consist of a free site transfer, priority technical support, super cacher for faster site speed, and free backup restores. The Startup plan is a great choice too if you plan on just having one website. You can always scale up to another plan anytime. If you hover over all essential features, you can see everything the plan includes. For the Grow Big plan or Go Geek plan, hover over the premium features and you can see what that includes. If you scroll down a bit, you can get more information on each plan, as you can see here. Once you know the plan that you want, click the orange Get Started button at the top of the page or the green blue Get This Plan button. You will now be on the Choose a Domain page. If you need to register a new domain name, just enter the domain that you would like to have. Once you type in your domain, it'll let you know if it is available or not. If you already own a domain name, select your already own a domain name option and enter in your domain name. Once you are done, click the Proceed button. The next step is to put in your account information, put in the best email address for you and the password you want to have for your Siteground account. Next, put in your information for the client information, put in your country, first and last name, the company name is optional, state or province, the city, street address, zip code, and phone number. Next, put in your payment information. Next, you will see purchase information. If for any reason you need to change the plan, click the square box to change your plan. You will see data center by default. It will choose the data center closest to you. Click the gray box with arrows to see the other data centers and change if you need to. Next, you will see period. Click this to choose how long you want to purchase your Siteground hosting plan for. I recommend going with at least a 12-month option so you can avoid the setup fee and save some money by doing so. Next, extra services. If you already own your domain name, two of the options regarding the domain name will not show up. If you registered your domain name with Siteground, you will see the domain registration fee. Domain privacy, I highly recommend, as this will keep your personal contact information safe so that your personal information is not out for everyone to get access to. By choosing this, your information will show Siteground's information instead of yours. Without domain privacy, more than likely you will get a good bit of telemarketers and marketers bugging you trying to sell all their services to you. Next, SG Site Scanner. This plugin will scan your site daily to see if there is any malware on your site or if you've been hacked. It'll let you know if this happens. All these extra services options are completely optional and you can always get one at a later date if you decide to. Next, agree to the terms and conditions. Select if you want Siteground news and special offers sent to your email address and click the Pay Now button. You've successfully purchased Siteground hosting. Siteground will email you a copy of your receipt. If you did register your domain name with Siteground, you will get a confirmation email that you'll need to confirm for the new domain you registered. Now we need to install and set up WordPress on Siteground. Now just log into your Siteground dashboard. You can do so by clicking login at the top on the Siteground website. Once you're logged in, this is what the Siteground dashboard looks like. Click My Account. You'll see a Go to cPanel button. Click this, click proceed. This is what the Siteground cPanel looks like. You will see auto installers, you'll see WordPress. This is where we'll be installing WordPress. First, let's install the free SSL certificate to make your site secure. Scroll down to the security section and click on Let's Encrypt. Click this. You will see it says you have no Let's Encrypt certificates installed on your account. Select your domain and click install. Once you install the free SSL certificate, you don't need to do anything else. It will automatically renew. Now go back to the Siteground cPanel like you see here. You will see auto installers. You'll see WordPress. Click WordPress. Next, find the Install Now link. Click this. You'll see HTTP. Click this and change to HTTPS. Now choose a domain name that you selected for your website. The directory keep blank. You don't want anything put in here. Now put in your site name. Put in a site description. My blog is dedicated to WordPress, for example, so my description is WordPress tutorial and resource site. Next, ignore the enable multi-site unless you are implementing that. Now put in your admin, username, and password in the admin email address. This is the information to log into WordPress. Select your language. Next, select if you want limit login attempts. This will limit the amount of time a wrong password or username is entered in to protect you from hackers. Next, you can select contact forms by WP/forms. This makes it easy for you to add contact forms to your site. Next, choose a theme. I just keep this to none. I'll be going over this here shortly. I wouldn't mess with advanced options unless you are experienced with the things listed under that. Click install. WordPress will now begin installing on your Siteground account. Give it just a few minutes. Once it is done installing, it will list out your WordPress admin URL. Click this to go to your WordPress login page. I would bookmark this link so you can easily access it, making logging in a quick process for you. To log into WordPress, the easiest way for the future is type in your domain name with a /wp-admin, just like you see here. This brings up the WordPress login URL. Now enter the WordPress username and password you picked out. You'll now be in the WordPress dashboard. On the far left, you will see tabs. Hover over them and get to learn them. Post is where you can add new posts. Pages is where you can add new pages. The media tab is where your images will show that you upload to your blog. Comments is where you can view comments people leave on your blog. Plugins is where you can install plugins for your blog. Almost any customization or feature that you would want, more than likely there's a plugin already made for it. Appearance is where you can pick out a theme or change the look of your theme or change your theme to another one or a premium theme. Select themes when you hover over appearance. It will showcase free WordPress themes that you can choose from. If you select most popular, it will show you the most popular free WordPress themes. Hover over a theme and click install and then click activate to make the theme your WordPress theme. You should also see add new theme on this page. This is where you can add a new theme if you got it from another site or it is a premium theme. A great resource I've used for several years and recommend for professional WordPress themes that look like an award-winning design agency did your blog is ThemeForest. This is the ThemeForest homepage. In the drop-down where it says WordPress, you can click on popular items to check out the most popular premium WordPress themes. You can easily search for your industry with WordPress after it to search premium WordPress themes. You can click a theme and you can click preview theme to see what the theme would look like live on the web. Here's a few examples of premium WordPress themes that are already pre-made for you to input your information or change however you'd like. You'll see they look really good. Click the link in the description below to check out ThemeForest. In the top left of your WordPress dashboard, you will see welcome here or your site title towards the top of the page. Click this to view your site. Another great resource that is helpful and used by over 500,000 users is the drag and drop editor called Elementor Page Builder. Elementor Page Builder makes starting and creating your WordPress site easy. You can make edits by dragging and dropping. Search Elementor Page Builder on the plugins page and install and activate it if you'd like to try it out. Elementor has a free and paid version. I provide a link in the description so you can check out and compare the features of the free and paid versions. And that is how to start a blog on Siteground. I hope you enjoyed this Siteground WordPress tutorial. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more WordPress video tutorials. Leave us a comment. We love hearing from you.